So there are eight ways that we create an ineffective choice. And when I talk about choice, that's how you should be creating. So I want you always to imagine that when you're choosing to create something, it's not you're not trying to solve a problem. And so if you ever think your life will be better or, you know, anything like that, you know that you're setting yourself up for failure, because if the problem is the only reason that you're motivated to go and have it, the problem is it has to exist. And so when we truly get into creation, we realize that we're just choosing what we want. Hey, Sarah, so you just jumped on. We're just choosing what we want rather than having to have a problem that motivates. And I think everyone is really starting to get that. You don't need a problem. You can just be totally happy and satisfied with where you are now and choose just to have something else, choose to have more. And I want you to own this. It's not better. It's just different. It's not better. It's just different. So the seed and the seedling of a tree, yes, it turns into a forest. The forest isn't better. It's just different. You see, there's just more. It's just a different experience. And this is really true for me at the moment as I experience my business. And I know that a bigger business isn't going to be better than now. See, one thing I always thought was when I was starting my business, well, bigger will be better, bigger will be better. But what I've noticed is if you're always in that, you never get to experience and enjoy now. How many parents on this call know that, you know, you only get, I think, was it 18 summers with your kids and then they're gone, right? You never get to have it again. So, you know, if you're always thinking, well, it's going to be better in the future, it's always going to be better in the future, you're missing the point, you see? You're missing the point. So the truth is right now has to be great. It has to be great. And you have to get into this place to enjoy not having what you truly want to enjoy. And when you get into that place of now is totally fine, then that's when you get into choice, not in problem solving. So, hey, Ed, so you just jumped on. So I want to talk about the ways that we create ineffective choice. And then I want to do some anchoring and things like that. So the first way that we have an ineffective choice is we choose via limitation. Okay. We choose via limitation. Type in a yes if they've done this before. You choose based on what you think is possible. So you choose by limitation. You're not just choosing what you truly want. You're like, well, you know, I'll go for that, or I can just have that. You choose by limitation. Now, limitation inherently isn't your true choice. You're just choosing by something that you think is limited. Like, we'll just have this, or I'll just go. And you're actually doing it from a place of feeling like you're incapable. So while I won't go for that, I'll choose just here. Now, it's also true that you can be choosing the big goal, but then even though you're choosing the big goal, you can have milestones along the way. So when I say choices, I want to read you out some of my choices so that you really get it, okay? And this is in the front of my book, okay? One of my choices is I choose the end result of owning highly profitable companies that make a positive difference. Another one is I choose the end result of building a massive tribe of high vibe, happy humans. Another one is I choose the end result of building the new education system that teaches the new way. The next one, I choose the end result of empowering millions to live their full potential through live events and programs. So those are choices, okay? And they're not limited, right? I choose the end result of empowering millions to live their full potential through live events and programs. So my choice is big, you see? But what I'm experiencing and loving experiencing now is I have 54 people at my event, right? So I choose to have that, but I'm also enjoying having 54 people. Type in a yes if you get it, is that my choice isn't limited, but at the same time, I'm not trying to go from zero to hero in one. I'm going, cool, that's what I'm choosing. And so I know where I'm going now. Does that make sense? So when I finish the event on Sunday, I'm like, yes, I choose the end result of millions. I feel like I'm building the forest. I'm watching it unfold, you see? And so I'm not choosing by a limitation. So that's the first way, you know, don't choose by limitation. Have big choices. I'm choosing to create this. I'm choosing to be this. I'm choosing to have this. And it's cool what I've got right now, you see? And next week, I'm not trying to have a million. I know, and I want you all to hear this, there's a perfect rate of growth, perfect rate of growth. And if you've ever looked at Fibonacci sequence, you'll see that nature has a perfect rate of growth. And I think it's 1.6. Okay, so the next choice, way that we have ineffective choice is Choice by indirectness. Okay, choice by indirectness. I know, Willina says you're developing your high vibe tribe. I am. All of them's happening, in fact. Well, all of them's happening. I've got the high vibe tribe. I choose the end result of total spiritual, financial, emotional abundance. I choose the end result of living in a self-sufficient paradise on a large estate. I choose the end result of a happy, fun, loving relationship with my partner in crime. I choose the end result of, I've already said that one. So no, they are all happening. I choose the end result of bringing spiritual technology to the world's population. So yeah, Will, they're all happening. They're all happening. By the way, those of you typing in, just check that you can send to all panelists and attendees if you want others to see your comments and chat with others. A few of you are talking to just me, but it's looking like you're trying to talk to others. So make sure you say hi to everyone. Okay, so choice by indirectness. Okay, a lot of people are choosing by indirectness, choosing the process instead of the result. Okay, so if you think about these, like I choose the end result of living in a self-sufficient island paradise, right? I chose that, just chose it as a result. I didn't choose that how I was going to do that, right? So I'm choosing the end of it. A lot of people choose... they choose to have a business, right? And they say, well, I'm creating a business. And you say, why? Because I want to travel. No, choose the travel. Because if you're choosing through indirectness, what's happening is you're trying to control how you get there. Does that make sense, guys? Like, I'm not trying to control how that happens. I'm saying that's what I choose. That's the end result. And however it comes is great, right? However that turns up is awesome. So when I choose the end result of a happy, fun, loving relationship with my partner in crime, I choose that, and then that gets to be experienced with Harriet and I. Does this make sense, guys? So a lot of us choose indirectly. So the key is you're much more motivated to have a business be profitable and work without you if it's designed to help you to do something that's really important, right? Like, I want to travel the world. Great. I want to travel the world. I want to have this. Cool. That's my choice. What do I need to do to have that? Well, I need to have my business make this much. Awesome. Now you've got what some people try to call your why. Type in a yes if that's making sense. You cannot choose through indirectness. You must choose what you want. See, most people don't have a choice for money. They don't. Most people choosing to have money is not actually a choice. It's normally they're choosing a process to get something else. Thanks, Sarah. Awesome. Okay, so the next way we choose via indirectness is choice by a limitation. So we eliminate all the other possibilities. Okay, so we make it so painful, we eliminate everything else, and then, oh well, I have to do this, you know, I have to be an accountant, I have to leave this relationship, I have to quit my job, well, I have to, you know, there is nothing else I can do. And this person, where do they put the power, right? When they do that, when the power is because it got so bad they have to do it, the power is not in them, you see. So what they're really saying is, I don't have the power to choose what I want, so I'm going to wait. I know what I want, but I'm not going to choose it. I'm just going to wait till everything gets really, really bad, and then I'm just going to have to go here, you see. And I do see that a lot of people, just they're not going for it. It's usually not the people in this program, so I won't go into it very much, but I see it out there in society. This is another one that I see in society, but not here, which is choice by default. Okay, this is the choice to not make a choice so that whatever results happen, they just occur. Who sees people do this? They just never choose. I don't really know what I want, right? I don't really know what I want to really do. I'm not going to choose. I'm just going to see what shows up, right? Who knows that? Who's seen people like that, right? And they're letting the world choose for them, okay? That is not making a choice. No choice is a choice of just giving all your power away. And, you know, we only get one life. And so that is completely ineffective. That is an ineffective way to choose what it is that you want in life. Okay, this one I do see from this. Yeah, right on, Peter. I do see this sometimes in this group is conditional choice, okay? Imposing preconditions on the choices. Okay, so a lot of us want to choose to be free, but in order to be free, we have to make $1 million, right? I see this in this group. Oh, I choose to be a successful speaker. Well, in order to be a successful speaker, I needed to have all of this. Who's guilty of this? Is it just me? We put conditions on the choice, right? Like, I want to have this, but in order to have that, I have to do this. And this is the only way. This is it. I can't have that until I have this, until the kids grow up, until I make enough. I can't go to Bali until I can't do this because I've got to do this. And so we put conditions. We're basically saying to the universe, is it just me, Aaron, and Wilhelmina? Is it just three of us? It used to be Sarah. I do this, and I know I'm aware whenever I'm doing it, I'm thinking, why don't I just choose to have it show up instead of with my controlling rule structure? like it's got to be this way, right? It's got to be this way. All right, so I see that. The next one is choice by reaction. Yeah. So, before I go into it, it's conditional choices. We need to just choose what we want and then decide how we think it's going to show up, but be open. See, a lot of us are going, you know what? I want to be rich, right? Well, what for? Well, because I want to have time freedom. Well, shit, just choose the time freedom, right? Who knows how else you could get the time freedom? You know, lottery turns up and gives you the time freedom. You know what I mean? Like a job comes up. You don't necessarily have to be rich to have it. Makes sense? And so you choose the end, not the conditions, not the process. Yeah, cool. So the next way is choice by reaction. Okay, this is where, and I had challenges. Scott and Hannah know that this is hard right now in some instances in my life to not choose by reaction. Instead to go, okay, cool, let's not react. Let's not react to that and go, oh, there's a problem, let's choose this. And let's choose what we really want. And sometimes when you're just in choice, you actually have to go create a conflict to keep your choice in alignment. So in instances in the last few months, I've had like clear choices I want, and then life has been going here, and it actually be easier and less, there'll be less conflict if I just let it be the way that. But as I know, this is the choice. I want this. Does that make sense, guys? So don't make choices based on reaction. Oh, here's a problem, so I'll go choose that. That's, you're not actually making a choice when you do that. Oh, look, a competitor is doing that product. Oh, look, that didn't work, so let's do this. And I've seen myself do this. And it's like, man, you've done it again. You've gone and seen that. And so the reason I'm telling you that, being vulnerable, is you've got to have awareness. As long as you go, oh man, I chose out of reaction, or I chose out of this, instead of just going, what is the true choice? What is true? What do you really love? What do you really want? I see choice by reaction to be one of the hardest ones for us to put down. One of the hardest ones for us to put down. Who follows that? It's very difficult when we see something we don't want to not then go create a solution for it. But what you must do is you must screw it up, say that it failed, call it a failure, put it aside, and then not trying to solve it, going, okay, that's gone. What do I choose? What do I choose? That's dead. It's done. I've thrown it away. It's done. I've called it a failure. It's finished. What do I choose? You see what I'm saying? See, the difference is, people aren't willing to call it a failure, to call it a thing and go, that sucked. And they keep on trying to fix the thing. And this is true even if the thing stays alive. Say it's a relationship, right? And it's not going the way you want. Instead of just keep trying to fix the relationship, you're better off going, hey, let's end the way we're in relationship. And now let's get and go, what do we actually want from a relationship and create what we want? Not from solving it. We say, all of that's done. It's gone. Type in a yes if you get it. It's gone. We're throwing that out. That one's finished. Let's date again, right? Let's create what we want now. What is it we really want? We're not trying to solve it. And the imagery I want you to get, it's like you're doing a painting, right? And you get to this point where you go, I can't make this painting work, right? You could keep trying to fix it, keep trying, or you just throw it out. Now, you're still going to keep painting. You're still going to keep painting, but you've thrown it out. You've just given it away. And the ability to just go, yep, cool. That's fine. The same people can be there. The same, everything can be there, but you're not trying to solve the thing that was there. You're just going, all right, cool. So that one's done, didn't work. Let's put it aside. Here we are. What are we creating? It is liberating. It is liberating. Yeah, Kevin says, Don't cling to a mistake just because you spent a long time making it. Yeah, it's true. And so I guess a lot of times we're choosing because out of reaction, and it's something for us just to go, you know what, it's okay to just go, that didn't work, and let it go. A lot of times we're so attached to one of our sabotage patterns of, I need to be good enough, or I need to be deserving, so I can never just say that I failed, you know? And you can even say that something failed, and like say a relationship, you can say that way failed. So we're not gonna try to fix it. Let's start it again, you know? Let's start a new one. Cool. All right, the next one is choice by consensus, okay? And this is where you only ever make a choice based off asking everyone else what they think you should do. Choice as, yeah, thanks, Sarah. Choice pro. The key is with this is when you put the power to the poll of what everyone else should think, you should do, you're giving away your power to say, I can just choose. Does that make sense? When it's always this consensus, what does everyone else think? What do they all think? And then you choose. You're not allowing yourself to build the strength and the muscle to just say, I'm in control. Because what it does is it gives you this little out where if it doesn't work, oh, well, everyone told me it was a good idea. So do you see the setup that you've made for yourself? If I ask everyone else, then if it doesn't work, well, then, you know, it wasn't me choosing. So you're creating yourself a setup which allows yourself not to just take responsibility for yourself, right? And so it's important that you choose and you create for you. And that includes helping other people do awesome things. And sometimes you have the choice of going, I need more information to make my own choice, you see. But you're not always in this place of, hey, what should I do? What should I do? You still can get info from others, but it's always you. It's you that's choosing. And then the last one is choice based on some metaphysical notion of the universe, you know, where you know, it was some sort of karma or in a past life, you know, you did something bad or, you know, because this, and, you know, I don't see it that much from you guys, but my mentor told me it was one of the ways that we create ineffective choices. So I still talk about it. Now, the point here is you guys need to, and we need to create some choices and really choose end results that are really, really, really crucial and really important for us. So who's up for that? Who's up for that? Good, 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 good. So let me ask you all a question. What is something that you will choose to create just because you'd love to create it? What is something you would choose, an end result? Now, I'd like you, if you are doing it, to type in a choice, a big choice, you know, and you can feel good to model some of mine. I'm going to read all my choices out for you. I choose the end result of living my true nature and purpose. I choose the end result of perfect health. I choose the end result of total spiritual, financial, emotional, and physical abundance. I choose the end result of living in a self-sufficient island paradise on a larger state. I choose the end result of a happy, fun, loving relationship with my partner in crime. I choose the end result of owning highly profitable companies that make a positive difference. I choose the end result of building a massive tribe of high vibe, happy humans. I choose the end result of bringing spiritual technology to the world. I choose the end result of building the new education system that teaches the new way. I choose the end result of empowering millions to live their full potential through live events and programs. Those are my choices. And so every day I make them, and I'm going to show you guys how. So I want a few choices from you. So I choose, and then fill it in. I choose the end result of a loving, respectful relationship with my stepdaughters. Beautiful choice. That is an end result. Do we choose the end result or what we see the end result is? Maureen, write down your choice. I'm not sure what you mean by that. So write in the choice and let's do it. And we'll push yourself. Let's even try to get a second one because I know you wrote that one down on Sunday as well. But maybe there's another one we can choose because I've got quite a few. So that's a good one, but maybe a one in your purpose for the world, or maybe one in health, or maybe one in finances, or one in, you know, fun, relationship. Yeah. Yeah, so I choose financial, emotional, spiritual joy for wonder through my music to move others. Nice, nice, nice. And it feels good. It feels good. I choose to live in a beach house in a beautiful location. I love that, Maureen. Beautiful choice. I choose the end result, happy, fun, spontaneous, loving, caring relationship. Boom, Mary. That's a great choice. I choose being fully self-expressed. No, so these ones aren't end results, okay? I choose to have $100 million in my bank account. For what? See, I always know it's not an end result when I know that it's leading. Like, what will that do? I mean, maybe you could say, no, Chris, that's what I want. Like, I love to see that in my, that's all I would love. I just don't think it's true. I choose to be an international speaker. All right, I like that. I choose to have unlimited resources. I choose to empower millions. I choose to have the best fulfilled life. I feel there's a theme there for you. And I won't read your name out because you sent it in to me privately. And by the way, guys, if you just send it to me, I won't read out your name. But if you send it to all panelists and attendees, I'll read it out and we can talk about it. But there's something underlying in all of those, which is, you know, I need to prove myself. Yeah. So I want you to really get in your heart and make, what do I really want? Here's the big question. What do I truly, truly want? Truly want just because I want it. I choose the end result, having an awesome time living my life every single day. I choose to enjoy every single day. That's a great end result. I love it. I choose the end result of being a top influential salesperson. I think that's the process. So I choose the end result of millions of people buying from me, or I choose the end result of 1,000 happy sales. You see, it doesn't matter whether you're a conscious salesperson or not, right? There's the end result. Does that make sense, Lexi? So instead of I choose the end result of a top influential conscious salesperson, I choose the end result of 1,000 people who loved buying from me, right? That's a much better, but even then that might even lead to something bigger, but it's nice. It's nice. Right on, Scotty. I choose the end result. Cool. Nice. Love it. Choose to help troubled teenagers. Yeah. So I choose to help them, but that, it feels like that's, you know, what do you want to create? What would be the end? You know, what's the big result? So I think that's through limitation there, Stephen. So I choose to create a training platform for teenagers, or I choose to create a safe house, or I choose to create a program. Yeah. Nice. I choose the end result of leading a healthy community through weight loss coaching. Yeah. So it's a little bit of limitation there. So I think the end result there, Will, was I choose the end result of leading a healthy community to their ideal weight. You see, because you've limited yourself to that one way that you can do it. Yeah, which it still might be that way, but it might not. That's when you know you can open yourself up. I choose to be 100% honest with myself and others. Why? What for? Like, what does that lead to? Does it lead to great relationships? What does it lead to? You know, I choose to be working with my genius. Now that's nice. I choose to have a productive relationship with money. Well, why? You know. The end result isn't to have a productive relationship with money. It's to have lots of it, or to enjoy it, or to, yeah, I mean, maybe. And by the way, I'm just giving ideas here. Choose to have a family that feels loved and is free. Beautiful end result. I choose to be fucking me. Nice. Good for you. I choose the end result of having a fit body, health, lifestyle. Yeah, good choice. I choose to have love and care. Yeah, nice. Glizzel, nice. Nice. Right on. I choose the end result of bringing joy to an ever-growing family of like-minded humans through. Yeah, cool. Well, so Mary, I love it. I choose the end result of a massive passive income stream. Yeah, it's a nice choice. I would just check in. Is it the income stream, or is it what you do with it? You know, is it, I choose to live, you know, in total financial abundance. I don't know. It's nice though. It's nice. I choose the end result of established meditation center near the Gold Coast. Yeah. Good choice. Cool. All right. You guys are getting it. You guys are getting it. Cool. So did everyone get a choice? Scotty's, how many do you want? Did everyone get a choice? I hope so. And if you didn't, choose at least this. If you didn't get one, we're going to do a process, but at least choose that you choose the end result of living true to yourself. Okay. So if you're like, oh man, this is too much today, Chris, I don't know. At least choose that, or I choose the end result of perfect health, right? Because you need both of those. So I'm going to teach you how to make a really solid choice. And this creates the intention in the field. Type in a yes if you know what anchoring is. Actually, type in a no if you've never heard of anchoring. Anchoring, where you set an anchor. Type in a no if you've never heard of it. I think most of us have, because the meditation, the way you do it is you get into a process and then you set an anchor of how you feel and you use the anchor to get there. Going once, going twice. No one needs me to explain it. Cool. So the couple anchors that I use is I normally will put a finger together like that, or I'll take my left hand and squeeze my right wrist to do it. Okay. So what we're going to do is I'm going to help you to really make a couple of really powerful choices and teach you this process. Okay. So we'll do the first one if you're ready. So if you don't have one that you feel good, at least do this one. I choose the end result of living my true nature and purpose. Okay. Awesome. So what we're going to do is we're going to choose it and set the intention with our eyes closed. And what you're going to do is you're going to notice what shows up. Okay. And you're just going to be open to see what shows up when you choose it. Awesome. Okay. So just settle in and just close your eyes. Just take a breath in through your nose and out through your mouth a couple of times and just feel the chair sort of holding you up. And now let's choose. So choose it in your mind or say it out loud. So I choose the end result of, and just choose it. And as you choose it, notice what comes into your mind. As you choose it, notice how you feel. And when you've got a feeling, go ahead and just put on an anchor and just press an anchor and feel it and say to yourself, I choose the end result of, and just put on that anchor and allow that feeling to be there as you choose that. All right, open your eyes and come back. Take your anchor off. Let me know, how was that? We're not finished, but how was the first part? How was that? What came to you? Was it good? Was it focused? Boom, epic, okay. It was good. Did anything pop into your mind that you didn't think? Or was it just normal? Happiness, light, easy, love it, Mary. Very clear. Couldn't get the feeling. Okay, cool. Excited, happy, loving, peaceful. Cool. Okay, so now we'll do the second part of it. Okay, we'll do the second part of it. That's all right, Sarah. Struggled a bit to get the feeling. It's all right. If you struggle to get the feeling, there's a part of you that won't let you receive it. So we'll work on it though. Okay. It's all right. So stay with me because the process will help those that didn't get the feeling. Okay, so second part. This time I want you to, without judgment, we're going to close our eyes and we're going to go exactly into how it is now. Okay, exactly into it now, and we'll have an anchor. I want you to use a different anchor. So if you use this knuckle, use this. If you were squeezing here like this, maybe then squeeze here or something else. But change, I want you to change the feeling. Okay. So go ahead and close your eyes. And I want you just to settle in for a second, close your eyes and ask yourself, compared to that, what's life like now? And when you got the feeling, go ahead and press down your knuckle. What does it feel like now to be here and not there? Breathe into that desire to have that where you're here, not there. Just feel it. It could feel peaceful, calm, whatever it is you want. What's it like to be here? All right, open your eyes and tell me, what was it like? What was the difference? What was the difference? What's the difference between the two? No difference. Awesome. What was the difference? Grateful, desire, good. Good, good. It's okay. So it's okay now, but over here is this, cool. Cool. Heavier, bit heavier. Cool. It was okay. It was the same. Good. 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 It was okay. Cool. Cool, good for you. That's all I want. It's just how it is. Busy versus leveraged. Right on. Right on. Okay, so now we want to find and be aware of what's in the way, what's in between. Okay. So the question that we must ask ourselves is, you know, when you're here and you want to be there, you know, what's in the way? So when you think about being here and wanting to be there, what are your thoughts and feelings? What are your thoughts and feelings that come up? I'm here, I want to be there. You know, what are thoughts and feelings that are in the way? What judgments do you have? And I would just explore this, write these down. What are your thoughts and feelings about being here and wanting to be there? How does it feel to be here and not there? How do you judge yourself? How do you judge yourself? I'm here. How do you judge yourself compared to it? Now, a lot of you haven't realized you can be putting positive judgments. I can do it. I feel good. But just what are the judgments? How do you judge yourself? How do you judge the goal? How do you judge the world? Right on. No, that's what's supposed to happen, Peter. Yeah. That means it's there. Any separation is where there's work. Yeah, nice, Mary. Nice. Good for you. Good to write down. So how do you finish the sentence? It'd be really nice to have that, but, da, 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 da. It'd be really nice to have that, but, oh, I'd really like to, but I've got all these things. I'd really like to have that, but there's this and this and this. How do you finish that? Nice. 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 Nice, nice, nice. Okay, so what we always do is we want to explore the future first, and then the second step, we've explored the current reality, okay? So now we've really explored these two. So we've done the first two parts of manifestation in choice making, all right? Is we've said, you know, this is where I want to be, and then this is now. We've actually just been exploring the now. What judgments or what things do I have about this, right? Which is cool. Now, the next thing we do is we go into the choice that we actually want to have. This is very important, okay? And we ask ourselves, what is the obvious next action? Okay, so we go in and we ask ourselves. Now, to do that, I need to teach you how to get into a really different energy, okay? So is it okay for me to teach and share with you a little bit of a way for you to get into a real observant energy? Have you ever seen like a baby or a child their first time at the beach? Have you seen the wonder in the eyes of like a small puppy the first time they come home? Who's seen this? Type in a yes if you've seen a kitten freaking out at a bit of plastic blowing in the wind. Who's seen that? And it's like they're experiencing it for the first time. They're just witnessing it. Like their eyes are wide and they're witnessing it. Like they have no idea what this thing is, and they have no blueprint to what it could be. So they're kind of just trying to figure it out. Have you seen this? Like this look, they're like, what is this? What's going on? Right? Can you just imagine that for a second, having no blueprint or any preconceived idea of what the heck this is, and just trying to just look at it and letting it show. Who can get into that energy, by the way, of complete wonder and amazement? Can anyone get into that energy? Type in yes if you can, where you're just in awe of a painting, and you're just in this awe of, wow, look at that. Sometimes we get this in nature or beauty. Can you get into that? Cool. That's the energy we need to get into when we're just waiting for the right next action to show up. We're just waiting. We're in awe, and the right action will show up. So can you guys all do that feeling? So that's what we got to get into, is don't try to consciously just whatever shows up. You're just witnessing what shows up, like a little bit of rubbish just blows in front of the kitten. What the heck is that? And Peter, you might need to quickly do the first two steps, but choose on your comedy career or something. You know, what would it be like? Where are you now? And now let's do this so that you can get the next step. Because if you already have it, that's awesome. That's awesome. That's awesome. So you guys ready for this? Yeah, baby's first time at the beach, Mary. So go ahead if you're ready and close your eyes. And I want you just to choose to be in awe. Just choose to receive. Just choose to be in wonder. That's it. And say to yourself, I choose the end result of, and choose it in your mind. Perfect health, true nature, purpose, whatever it is. Just choose it. I choose the end result of. Really choose it. Go there. Be there now. I choose the end result of. Now, you've got your anchor to get you back in the feeling. So if you need to, squeeze that anchor, get back in the feeling. I choose the end result of. And now that you're there, that's it. Now that you're there, look back at the version of you that doesn't have this and get that sense of wonder or amazement or awe of the baby's first time at the beach or the cat, the kitten playing with a piece of rubbish for the first time, or just amazement. Feel that wonder and amazement as you ask yourself, what was the obvious next step that I took to get from there to here? And just ask that question and let it come. You know, when you've got it, you can open your eyes and type it in. Just ask the question and wait for it to show up. It'll come up as a word, a movement, a sound, a color, but it will turn up. Let me know by typing in your next step. Nice. Thanks, Alexi. If you're having trouble with it, go in there, get into the amazement, get in the end result and ask yourself with your heart wide open, what was the next thing I had to do to get from there to here? Nice. Nice, Maureen. I agree, Hannah. I got patience for us. Where's Scott? I got patience. Nice. Trust myself more. I know what to do. Anyone having challenges with this, type in a me. So if you need help, let me know. Awesome. So what is it that you want? And then where are you now? Step into the end result and ask yourself, what was the next step that went from here to here? Just get really open. Ask yourself and stop trying to know. Stop trying to know. Just open. Just stop trying to know. Let go of needing to know. The cat, the kitten, they don't need to know. Nice. Well, choose to be kind where you could be critical. Awesome. Sarah, Glizelle, did that work? Two of you having troubles with this? Accept the love. Nice. Beautiful. Well done, Glizelle. That's it. So this is there's the next step. Okay. So we've chosen what we want. We've noticed where we are now. We know our next step. Type in a yes if you're with me. You know what you want. You know where you are now, and you know your next step. Brilliant. 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 Most of you are typing in yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, cool. Oh, I got it. I got it. Nice, Peter. It sounds like a good next step, man. I got what you mean, though. You couldn't get into the future feeling. Yeah. Okay, so here's the question. When you look at that action you need to take, be honest with yourself. How much resistance out of 10 do you have for taking that action? How much resistance out of 10? Type it in. How much resistance out of 10 do you have? Nice. 5, 7, 7, 3, 5, 5, 5. Cool. So a lot of you got resistance. 0, sweet, 6, 5. Cool. So we're going to do the recode process, which is where we ask your superconscious to treat the resistance and allow it to have more satisfaction in life. And so the key for the recode is you have to remember that you created it. And so you've created this resistance to stay safe. And so just ask yourself, well, what's the benefit of the resistance? What's the benefit of this? Like, why did I create it? It's usually to stay safe. It's usually to protect a controller that's trying to keep you there. Or maybe it's another thing is maybe you don't want to be judged, so you judge first. But just ask yourself, Well, anxiety is resistance. Anxiety is resistance. Yeah, it's a, so that's a feeling. So just ask yourself, that anxiety is stopping you from taking the action. So you're resisting the action. Yeah. So resistance is like a word that encompasses everything. And so you got to ask yourself, what benefit does that anxiety or that resistance give me? And usually it keeps us safe. But we got to remember, we created that. There's a reason why it's been created. And when you realize that you're three different consciousnesses, the first consciousness is your ego, your conscious self, the part that you that's thinking. The second is your unconscious, the part of you that keeps your body functioning. And then the third part is your superconscious, the part of you that your higher self that's been there forever, that's there just to create for you. So you have the power to recode. You have the power to allow any of the resistance to pop up into your active experience like little gophers and run away. So if it's okay for you guys, we can do the recode and for me to talk to your superconscious. So if it's okay for me to talk to your superconscious and for you to let go and treat, type in a yes or just nod to yourself because I'm going to do it anyway. And if it's totally okay, then I will. I'll connect with that part of you. And we'll let it go. And we'll let it go. Cool. So go ahead. If you are ready to let it go and to move forward, and just close your eyes and superconscious, can I connect? Thank you. Awesome. So superconscious, do you see this resistance? Please do a massive change history on all resistance to this action, emotions, beliefs. Please go back to the original event and do a massive change history and everything. And just breathe into that as you notice what you need to notice, getting moved into your active experience. Just breathe. You don't have to do anything, just breathe and notice it. Superconscious, do you see any emotions like anxiety or fear or nervousness or worry? Any stress emotions, please bring them into the active experience. Go back to the original event and do a massive change history and everything in the perfect way, in the perfect order. Thank you. Superconscious, I want you to bring up any resistances around commitment. I will take this action. I can take this action. I'm already taking this action. I am this action. I have the ability to take this action. And bring any resistance up around that into the active experience. And in the perfect way, in the perfect order, do a massive change history. Thanks. Superconscious, can you bring anything up around change? I will change. I can change. I'm already changing. I have the ability to change. I'll do whatever it takes. I'll do whatever it takes. Superconscious, anything in relation to any of those statements, especially, I'll do whatever it takes. Bring those into the active experience in the perfect way and do a massive change history. Thank you. And just breathe into that one, guys. Superconscious, anything that needs to be treated today in order to reduce the resistance down so this action can be taken easily and effortlessly, including energy systems, chakras, Chinese medicine, meridians, stress levels, endocrine system, personalities, and any other parts to join in on the treatment, please ask them to join in for one last change history and everything else. Take five big breaths, guys. Notice what you need to notice. And come on back. So we're conscious, please strengthen the beliefs we've touched today, the memories we've touched today with positive emotions, memories, and strong reinforced beliefs. When you're back, you can open your eyes. One thing to be careful of is if you went into your end result and asked what the next step is, just take the step that your future self told you when you were in that wonder, because sometimes we can actually find other things we need. And it might not be true. I'm just letting you know. Sometimes we can find other things we need to do to avoid what we're supposed to do. And so a lot of times if another step comes up, I think to myself, oh, gee, I really should just do the thing that my future self told me was the next step. But I'll leave that up to interpretation because I don't obviously know. So guys, did we have a good session today? I hope that we all did. That's how I make my choices, all right? That's how I make choices. And so every day I ask myself, and so some of them, there's no resistance. There's no resistance. Cool. I'm good. For example, I'm living in the house, you know, I've got the tribe, I've got this, but then a lot of times, hey, this is in my way, that's in my way. What I know is that we will always take the path of least resistance. And so if there's an action you need to take and you're not taking it, it's because there's something in the way, right? It's obvious. If you're supposed to take it and you want to be there and you're not taking it, it's obvious that there's something in the way. And so you must always know that, right? It's not you. There's something that you have created in your past and it's there and that's what's in the way. It was useful before, but now it's not so useful. And so that's how I make choices.